Hey everybody, this is James Zapp from the Dapper Den Barbershop in Richfield, Connecticut, and today we're going to be going over the Oster Classic 76 and the Andis Supra ZR2. Which one's better and which one should you buy? Thanks so much for watching this. If you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button, hit that like button. There's a bell somewhere over there that you can hit. That'd be great. And also be sure to leave a comment down below on which clipper you think is better and which one you think people should buy after reviewing this. So the reason we're going over these two clippers is because after quarantine, which we've been dealing with right now, we needed to cut back on some time, and some of our clippers weren't cutting through hair fast enough, or they were jamming up a little bit because of so much hair and volume that we were cutting. So when you start going over something with a rotary motor like a Classic 76 or a Supra ZR2, it really cuts down on time and it just slices through the hair so quickly and so fast. So the first one we're gonna go over is the Oster Classic 76. This has been around for a long time in the barbering industry, and there's a reason it's been around for so long, is that it just does its job and it works so well. All these, before going to it, are detachable blades, which you just pop off like this. They come off, you stick one on, you put it on. Most people don't use clips on these. I have seen some people put some clipper guards on these. I wouldn't recommend it. I would recommend getting the guards, or I'm sorry, the blades on them. Double rotary motor. It comes with about a 9-foot cord, give or take. Durable switch. This thing is built to last. It's in a pretty solid container. Feels good in hand. It's bulky, but the motor in it is super powerful. A little on the loud side, you can hear it kick on, but we are gonna do a decibel test in a little bit, so stay tuned for that. Another great thing about these Oster ones is that the parts to get are super easy to find. You can just find whatever part that you need and get it replaced, as opposed to buying a whole new clipper. This clipper will run you around, I think on Amazon, it's about $150 or $155, which we'll leave the link to below that you can check out. And they do sell some packages that come with like the oil, a couple blades and stuff like that. I think if you buy this just at a brick and mortar store, it does come with a one blade and it comes with a 000 blade. So you do get some blades. For both of these, the blades are pretty expensive. So if you're thinking about getting a detachable blade clipper, keep in mind that if you're gonna start getting every number blade, it's gonna be around $25 to $30 a blade, and we'll leave a link down to those. But one thing that I will talk about before I go into the Supra is that I've noticed personally that they are interchangeable, so you could use an Andis detachable blade on an Oster and vice versa on that. So the next one we're going to talk about is the Supra ZR2 by Andis. This one is pretty cool. The benefit right away is that it's cordless. So that whole idea of having a cord being attached to one spot is kind of gone away. Another cool feature about this is it does have 5 speeds on it. So when you turn it on, do, re, mi, fa, so. This also comes with, I believe, 2 clippers. It comes with a 000 and a number 1. And I think, I'm not 100% sure, but when this one came with it, I think it came with the ceramic blades on it. They run about 30% cooler. Which is great because these things can heat up very fast. This rotary motor is really strong. You're talking about, I think it's close to like 3,400 strokes per minute, which is fast. And this thing will cut through hair really fast. We are gonna do a decibel test on all these. Also, something cool about this is it does have a detachable battery to it. So if you have another battery that you have plugged in and you're cutting hair and you're running out of battery, you can just switch this in really quick and pop it in. A little bit of a negative on this one, as opposed to the Oster, which is about $150, give or take, on Amazon, you're looking at close to $300 for this one. So if that's a benefit to you with having cordless, that's great. I do think the Oster works just as well with the cord and the 5 speeds. Personally, I never use a different speed. I've probably always got it on max at the 3,400 or 3,800 strokes per minute. But the detachable battery is also a really cool thing. I don't think any of them come with detachable batteries. So you're gonna have to buy another battery on top of that. And then you're gonna have to also buy more blades with it too. So you're already looking at close to maybe you know, $500 if you're really kind of getting all the accoutrements with it. But we're gonna do a decibel test really quick. But before I talk about that, because the speed is so high on both of these, you have to be very, very careful when cutting hair. You wanna be made aware of whether a client has moles or skin tags or anything like that, because this will cut into it. It is a very fast clipper and it doesn't stop. It will cut through thick hair and it won't jam up. Some of the other clippers we have that are very good clippers, but when you go through such a amount of hair that the clipper gets jammed up because it can't cut that much hair in that amount of time, this will slide right through it like cutting butter. Got a graphic of butter over here with a hot knife. it's just pretty much the equivalent of that. It's like a hot knife through butter, and it will cut through somebody. So make sure that your client doesn't have any moles or any skin tags or anything like that. Also, be very careful about going around the ears with these, because you can also clip an ear if you're not paying attention or anything like that, or your client's moving a lot. So definitely don't recommend these on kids. If your kid, if a kid is moving around a lot, that's probably not the best clipper to go with. But yeah, let's do a sound test real quick so you can hear them both, and then we'll talk about it a little more. So you can see that the volume is relatively the same with the Oster and the Andis. When the Supra is at full power, the Oster is just a little bit louder, but obviously when you bring the Supra down to the lowest setting, it's about 10 decibels softer. Both are fantastic, fantastic clippers. They do the job really well. I, believe it or not, am personally the fan of the Oster only because of the price point, in that it's cheaper to get the clipper, get the blades that you need. The cord, if there's any problems with it, if it breaks, you can just get the part really quick. The Andis is pretty expensive, especially if you're gonna get another battery to have charging while you're doing that. But another benefit of the Andis that I like personally is it has a stand that you can actually put the clipper in, which helps out with not many cables running through your whole setup and stuff. You can just put it on the stand really quick and grab it and not have to worry about plugging it in or anything. So both are great. Please leave a comment below which one that you prefer. Also, you could talk about something else like the BGCR, I think it is. TJ's gonna check that, see if I have the right pronunciation. It's BGCR, I think it's the, you have no idea right now, do you? Okay, so check out that. If you also like that one as well, which is an Andis corded one before the Supra came out. But yeah, check them out. Check out the blades, we'll leave the links in the descriptions, but also please subscribe, like the video, hit that bell thing or whatever the hell it is. And thanks so much. If you like our stuff, check out our website, www.dapperdenbarbershop.com. Also follow us on Instagram at the Dapper Den Barbershop. Thank you so much for tuning in, and stay tuned for more videos.